Very good morning, dear students. I hope all of you are safe and fine at your home. So, dear students, today we will revise our English literature first chapter, that is The Owls in the Family. You must have read the story and revised the question answers and word meanings as well, but we will practice it once again. So, I have written some word meanings here over the board and I will explain those word meanings to you. So, the first one is full-fledged. Full-fledged means something which is completely developed, completely grown up, okay, fully developed. Then veranda. Veranda, it's a kind of place in our houses, you must have seen. It's a roof, open area attached to the front of the house. हम सबके घरों में जो आगे जो फ्रंट व्यू होता है वहां पे आगे अटैच्ड होता है बट ऊपर से इट इज कवर्ड विद द रूफ ओके देन क्लैट क्लैट मीन्स To make sharp sound or chattered loudly. Birds often do like this. Then threatening. Threatening means frightening. Something which is very scaring. Dra dene wala. Okay? Persuade. Sorry, I have written the wrong spellings here. Persuade. Persuade means to convince someone to do something. Get someone agree to do something. Kisi ko kisi cheez ke liye manana. Then inquiring. Inquiring means investigating. Investigate करना, कुछ पूछना, जानने की कोशिश करना, उसको investigating कह देते हैं. Emerged means moved out of something. Suddenly कोई चीज एकदम से बाहर आए आपके सामने आ जाए तो emerged word हम use करते हैं. Emerged, moved out of something or appeared. Okay? Then gurgled. Gurgled is also kind of sound. Made a sound of contentment. Contentment means satisfaction when we are satisfied. जब हम कहते हैं कि हम I'm happy, I'm satisfied, then we use this thing. So gurgled means made a sound of contentment. Then swooped. Swooped is a kind of movement. Moved rapidly downwards. Okay. Then we have ledge. Ledge is a kind of surface, it's a place, a horizontal surface on which we can keep something. Agile means something which is very fast or active, super active. So able to move quickly or very fast. Then infested. Infested means full of beetles or insects. You must have noticed sometimes in our houses wherever wooden furniture is there or doors are made up of wood, sometimes they are infested with the insects. Right? So they eat up the whole wood. So we can call that some insects are grown up there, collected there. Then soothing. Soothing means relaxing, something which gives us very pleasant feeling, calming or pleasing. Then terrible. Terrible, something which is extremely bad or awful, very terrible experience. Right? Then shrieks. Shrieks is a kind of screams when we shout in sharp voices. Okay? So these are the word meanings and now we will revise our question answers reference to context. Now our first extract is I had play still my head. The first question is where was the narrator? So we all know, we have read in the story, where was the narrator? The narrator was in his garden. Then what had he placed on the mango tree? What was he stooping to pick up? So what had he placed there? We read in the story, he had placed one of the baby owlets. Who was owlet? Owlet are the babies of owls. So owlets on the mango tree, he was stooping to pick up the second baby owl. Then who gave him the heavy blow? So who gave him the heavy blow? The mother owl gave him a heavy blow. Okay? Then extract, next extract. I got the feeling with a soft woo woo. So, then question is who according to the narrator was feeling sorry? So who was feeling sorry? The mother owl was feeling sorry according to the narrator. Right? Then B part. How did she show she was feeling sorry? So, in what way she expressed that she was sorry for the narrator? She was feeling sorry by greeting them with a soft woo woo. So, she was making soft sounds. right? Then next is C part. Why had she come there? Now, she had come there because she had realized that the narrator's home was the safest place for her young ones. So she came there back because when she realized, she thought that no, the narrator's home is the safest place. No other place is safest for her kids or for her young ones. Okay. Then next extract is, so the two owlets are liking to. First question is, do these lines suggest that grandmother liked most pets or that she did not like most pets? So answer is, these lines suggest that grandmother did not like most pets. So in these lines we get to know that mother, the grandmother, she did not like most of the pets. Then part B, who were the members of the household besides the grandmother? Apart from grandmother, who were the other members in the house? So the answer is, the owlets were the members of the household besides grandmother. Okay, so the owlets were the other members there. Then next is C part, which member of the household did not like the owlets? How do you know? Apart from the grandmother, which other members did not like the owlets? So the answer is, Aunt Mabel did not like the owlets. She was terrified of them and would run screaming from the room every time the birds went close to her. So क्या होता था? जब भी Aunt Mabel को नजर आते थे, वो वहाँ से भाग जाती थी. She would run screaming from the room every time. जब भी birds उसके close उसके पास आते थे. Then next is read, reflect and write. Question number 6 is, what do you know about the house where the narrator lived? Describe it based on details given in the story. So the answer is, the narrator's house had a huge veranda with steps. There was one garden with a mango tree in it. The kitchen of the house was infested with pests. There was a rainwater pipe emerged through the roof. So here it would be infested. You can correct it. F will come here. Okay. So the in question it is asked, narrator ke ghar mein jahan pe wo rehta tha, usko describe karna hai, wo kaisa tha aur kya kya cheeze thi. So narrator house had a huge veranda with steps, जो stairs होती हैं, staircase होते हैं, और वहाँ पर एक बहुत बड़ा garden था with a mango tree in it. The kitchen of the house was infested. It's infested with pests, and there was a rainwater pipe emerged through the roof. Okay. Then next is, list 6 sounds of an owl that the narrator has given in the text. So what are the 6 sounds are there? We can say 6 sounds of an owl that the narrator has given in the text are hissed, clacked, gurgled, crooned, woo-woo, shrieked. So all these are the sounds which we studied in this chapter. Okay. Then next question is, how did the owlets show their affection for grandmother? So, jo owlets hai, unhone kaise ye show kiya ke they were attached to the grandmother? They were very much affectionated towards her. So, answer is, the owlets would make gentle and soothing sounds in response to grandmother's voice. Jab bhi grandmother koi awaaz deti thi ya kuch bhi baat karti thi, तो वो उसके रिस्पांस में उसको जेंटल और सूदिंग साउंड से रिप्लाई करते थे. एंड दे बिगेन टू शो अफेक्शन टुवर्ड्स एनीवन इन अ पेटीकोट. और भी किसी ने भी वैसी ड्रेस पहनी होती थी तो वो हर उस लेडी को वो प्यार से देखते थे और प्यार से ट्रीट करते थे. राइट. देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, हाउ डिड द मदर आउल शो दैट शी केयर्ड फॉर द लिटिल ऑलेट्स? Answer, the mother owl had left a mouse with its tail tucked through the mosquito net to feed them. It showed that she cared for the little Owlets. So how she showed that she cared for them? Because she left something for her Owlets to feed them, right? Okay, so question number 10 is, did the narrator and his grandfather treat animals or birds with respect? Give reason for your answer. So how the narrator treated? We'll read the answer. Yes, the narrator and his grandfather treated the birds and animals with respect. They took good care of the Owlets. They gave them meat to eat and water to drink. And after the birds grew well, they took them into the garden to release them. So we, as we studied in the chapter, that narrator and his grandfather, they were very caring towards the Owlets. They treated them in a very good manner. They provided them food to eat, water to drink. And after the birds were grown well, they took them into the garden to release them so that they can live on their own. But it did not happen so. Okay. So I hope all of you will do the written revision of all these question answers, reference to context and read, reflect, write. And soon I will be sharing some test assignments with you based upon this chapter also. And your online tests are going to be conducted maybe by the next week. So do your revision well. And I will get back to you soon. Thank you. Have a good day.